My point is that coaches need coaches. You can't do it by yourself. Okay, so a couple ways to assess hamstrings. The hamstring crosses two joints, right? It crosses the knee joint. It crosses the hip joint. So I need to look at it in two different ways. The first one is I need to look at it by taking all the slack up at the hip. And then the other one is I need to take all the slack up at the knee. Okay? I wrote an article a while ago about called Hamstrung. Look, the single biggest way to improve your performance is to stretch and mobilize your hamstrings. It's like taking a gigantic handbrake off your Ferrari. Take the brake off. And what I'm talking about specifically, I'm going this side so you can see, is that he relaxed that leg for me. Okay? So here he is. Oh. Okay, just floppy thoughts with your athletes. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take him to 90 degrees. So that thigh is strapping down. You're all, watch this because you're going to be responsible for this. And if you can't go home and stretch your mom, you have a problem. Then I'm going to extend the leg, okay? That is the end of his hamstring range. So right now I feel no resistance in the muscle belly. There's nothing. It's free range there. And then literally right there, I have range. So right now, I'm starting to feel the effects of the handbrake on the system. Builds, 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 tight, and it ends right there. That's the end of his hamstring range. Can you see that? And it literally feels like there's no resistance, and then there's a little resistance, and then, oh, it builds quickly. He should be 5 degrees off straight up and down. All of our 5 degrees off straight up and down. There should be nothing until 5 degrees off straight up and down. 5 degrees off straight up and down. That leg should be straight.